learners, welcome to Start Coding Tamil. This is your Divya. Today's video we are going to discuss about the strings and character. We know what are strings, which is the strings which are the sequence of words which will be encoded by the enclosed by double quotation. In the same way, the character is a single letter which will be enclosed by a single quote, that is called character. And we are going to discuss how to compare the strings and also discuss about the character methods. What are the methods we have in the character class and how we are going to use that character methods. Okay, so let's get started. Today I'm going to use created a class which is compare strings with the main method. In this program is going to get an input from the user and going to compare the two strings which is equal or not. That's it. Okay, so let's get started. The first name is string. String, I'm giving a first name. Okay. I'm giving as a John. And the next one is string. Second name, I'm not initializing it. I'm just going to put the semicolon at the end of the second name. And I'm going to get the second name from the user. So use scanner to get the input from the user. So I'm declaring the scanner class. Okay, scanner of system.n and assign the user input to the second name. And I'm going to check first name equals second name. Here you have to know the difference, okay? Because here I'm going to compare two strings. Do you think we can use the equal to symbol? Because we cannot use the equal symbol, we can use it for numerics. Okay, if it is an integer or double, we can use the equal symbol for the integers. If you are using the equal symbol to compare the strings, what will happen means it will compare the memory address of each string. If the two strings of the memory address are same, then it is going to print true. But we want to check the content of the variable should be same, right? For that, I cannot use equal to symbol. If I use equal to, if equal symbol, then it is going to check the memory address. I don't want to check memory address. I want to check the content. For that, I'm going to use, there is a method called equals. If it is equals, I'm going to say strings are equal. Else it's going to print strings are not equal. And one more thing you can use, we have a two types of method. One is equals and other one is equal ignore case. Can you see here this equal ignore case? It means, okay, first I will show the output so that you can find the difference of how to use this one. So I'm running this. I'm going to enter the input, that is the same thing John. It's saying strings are equal. Okay, here I can give I have to mention the user. He has to know right when to enter the name. So enter the name. Let's see, I'm going to run it again and see the difference. Now I'm going to give that all the letters to be lowercase, and it says strings are not equal because in the first name we declare J as a J has upper J we specified as uppercase, but in enter the name when we are giving the second name it all are lowercase. So when you are using equals, so it will check the lowercase and uppercase. But if you want to avoid the case checking, you can use equals ignore case. So now I'm running it and giving the same thing. John, strings are equal. Okay. The other thing we have is compare to method, which is always returns a integer. Okay, based on that we will assign it's true or false. If it is written 0, it means the two strings are exactly same. If it is written the negative number, then the calling object is less than the argument. If it is returns a positive, then the calling object is more than the argument. So let's see here an example. I'm using the same thing. So first name dot compare to of second name. If it is greater than 0, okay, value, okay, I'm going to print the value of this what it is returning, okay, so that you can identify the difference. Else, if it is the same thing I'm giving. Here I'm mentioning else part. Okay, if it is greater than, if it is a positive value, it comes in the first loop. If it is a negative, okay, or 0, it will comes in the second loop. So I'm going to run this again. Now I'm going to give the name Anita. So strings are not equal. Value is -23 because it will always compare the first letter with the first letter of the first name and the first letter of the second name. So how far, if for example, if I take the example of Roger and Robert, okay, R and O in R and O, here the first name and second name, it are same. And the third word G is, and the second name it is a B. So here the G is 5 letters ahead, okay, after the B in the alphabet. That is what we are giving like this. So if I am giving to give it as the same, because if it is a -23, you cannot identify how the, where is the changes happening. So I am going to give here Roger, okay. I'm going to run it. I'm giving here as a Robert. Okay. Here the value is -32. Yeah, because it checks with R and R, even the lowercase and uppercase has some value. So that's why it's showing me like that. If you want to run it again, So when you are using a compare to method, you have to be we always use based on the integer when we will assign it to the, if it is greater, do something, do action, or if it is false, then do some other action like that. So see the value of 5, because here now I am giving R, and R is uppercase and O and O are lowercase. The next one is G and the next one is B. Here the G is coming after 5, okay, after the B, 5 letters ahead. So that's why it's showing 5. So this is the difference in using the compare to and equals method. And now I'm going to talk about character methods. So this class is already, I made this one here. It's the class name is character methods. I'm declaring a character. Yeah, I told you before itself to define a character. A single letter will be enclosed by a single quote. That is called character. So it's a character, and also I'm defining another variable, and I'm printing the character, and I'm using the character class. In the character class, we have is uppercase, is lowercase, two lowercase, two uppercase, is letter or digit. We have so many methods, but in this program, I used some of the commonly used methods. So if I'm checking character is uppercase of name char, if it is a small one, so it says name char is uppercase, else it is not uppercase. I'm checking whether it is a lowercase or not a lowercase. If I want to change it to lowercase, I will use two lowercase of name char. And if I want to change it to uppercase, I use character dot two uppercase. If I want to check whether it is a letter or digit, I will check this letter or digit. So the syntax is you have to use the class dot and the method name. Inside the method parenthesis, you have to give the argument. That is whatever you are going to check, the variable name. Okay, so let's run this one. So here we see the first C. Yeah, we are checking it's not uppercase. Yeah, it's a lowercase. I'm changing into lowercase, so it changed, and then it changed to uppercase. Then yes, it is a letter or digit. Okay. So this is the example for the strings and character methods. So we have so many methods, practice it. If you have any questions, post your questions in the comments below. If you like this video, please thumbs up, share with your friends, start sharing my channel, and subscribe to Start Coding Tamil. To get an automatic update, click the bell icon. Thank you all.